Hello, my name is Brent Blacklock, and I'm a CPA with TPP, Certified Public Accountants in Overland Park. And I'm excited to tell you about a class through the 2018 Brass Series that I'm going to be presenting on September 25th of this year, called Understanding Financial Statements. And I wanted to talk a little bit, even though there's going to be a lot of opportunities for you to ask questions, wanted to tell you a little bit in advance on what I plan to cover in the class, so that you can begin to think about that and communicate to others that might be interested. One of the things I really like to cover is the basic four financial statements. Everybody's heard of the P&L. That's the most common thing that everyone's heard of, and people's favorite thing to do on the P&L is go to the bottom line and see what it shows. There's really a whole lot more to financial statements than the P&L. P&L doesn't necessarily, for example, translate to profit in profit or cash in the bank from that profit. There's also three other very common financial statements that we want to cover and talk about what they mean and what key information you can get from those. In addition to that, there's actually several different methods of accounting that can be used and applied to financial statements, and you get different results using different methods, wildly different results in a lot of instances. I want to talk about three of the most common methods of accounting and how those would relate to you and your business and ended up playing out on your income tax returns. Another topic I'd like to cover would be the types of formal financial statements that a CPA can prepare. Probably about everybody has heard of an audited financial statement, but that's for small business owners, that is definitely not the most common financial statement that a CPA would prepare. There are a couple other financial statements that CPAs can prepare that are very helpful and that can probably get you and those outside users, for example, the bank, the information that they need on a lot more cost-effective level. So we're going to cover the differences of those. Furthermore, I'd like to do a case study. A lot of you may be familiar with QuickBooks. It's very popular among business owners, and I've seen a lot of good things happen out of QuickBooks. I've seen a lot of not so good things happen out of QuickBooks. And I want to do a little case study where we'll have an example, we'll have some sample financial statements, and we'll look at some financials and hopefully train everybody on how to see information just by looking at the financial statements in a real practical way. Of course, since I'm a CPA and we've had some comprehensive tax reform, I really also want to slide some practical suggestions and things to implement or consider implementing in 2018 for the tax reform that was passed near the end of last year on December 22nd of 2017. There's a tremendous amount of good things that can benefit business owners, and I really want you to hear about that before the year is over so that you can plan and react. Finally, I'd like to talk about why you need a CPA. There's a lot of good reasons on why you need a CPA, and I'd like to touch on that at the presentation. During the presentation, I would love to have a lot of interaction with questions, and part of the goal of this Brass Series is to have good tailored information to the business owners that are attending so that they can't just get something theoretical, but that they can get something that's practical that they can apply to their business and really make a change that benefits them. So I hope you like what you're hearing about this class. If you do, please come along. I'd love to see you in class on September 25th. Invite any other business owners you know. And if you've enjoyed what you're hearing today and are interested in learning more, I'd love it if you would like, subscribe, and share on YouTube. And we'll see you in class on September 25th. Thank you.